Hi everybody, I thought we'd have a look at another very simple stitch, and it's used most likely like this, but
blanket stitch. So let's just have a quick look. How's it done? Holding this out the way, bringing that thread underneath that needle. What we have is, that's what we're aiming for, so it creates a nice little edge. And so I hold that out the way, needle into the center and out to the edge, just like that, a little bit further along, then like that.
Now let's have a look at some variations on this stitch.
Let's just start with a blanket stitch. Like you can see, I've got a brown piece of fabric. I've put a little bit of a bluey colour on top just to denote sky. I thought, let's see if we can do a little landscape. I'm going to stagger it. I'm going to do some longer, some smaller, just to show you the variations that you can do. It doesn't have to be the same. I can go up in a big rather than go in a straight line there. I've gone up. I'm going to do a curve and see how that works as I go back down to the line that I was originally on. You see what I mean? So these are all different ways that you could use it to perhaps make something different. So I was just having a go at that, and then I thought, okay, I'll just do a little bit more, might drag it down here. We can also go out to the side. It doesn't have to be straight to that line. So maybe I'll do one that direction. So that's all blanket stitch, and it could be used, I think, to create all kinds of things. So let's have a go. So I thought maybe we could use that to create grasses.
So I thought to have a go at using a few different colours and making it all very random, but doing a few more layers on top of what I'd already done, you know, to look like natural grasses. Different colours and different sizes would help it look more natural. So I gave that a little go. You can't really see that one too well, but we'll see it in the next little bit. And then I thought, okay, well, what else could we do? We could use a little bit of wool. Maybe I want to add a little bit of colour and use the blanket stitch on it. So we're still getting that lovely grassy kind of shape towards the top, but we're also holding down that lovely green piece of wool. And that helps build our landscape too. So that worked out quite well, I think. So I'm just continuing that on a little ways, just adding to this grassy hill kind of shape that we've got going on, and then we'll have a go at something a little bit different. So all of that I did before had the line, the edge, at the bottom. So now I'm going to actually make the edge at the top. Same way, I've just turned it upside down. But I just thought, well, maybe that could look like little bushes or something like that. The more you do it, the more you can see that you could use it for all kinds of things. Let's have a look at this horizon. Some are facing up and some are facing down. And you can continue the theme using different layers of different colours on top of each other. But right now we're going to have a look at another use. And I'm going to start with making a little leaf shape. So using it just like normal, making the edge on the outside, you just bring it up the same as you would, getting larger in the center and then taking it in smaller at the point. There we go, that's the point now, straight up. There we go. And then you turn it around and you would go back again. Can you see that? It's a little leaf shape. So we could do that, or we could do flowers. So let's have a little go at a little garden. This time I'm going to make the straight edge on the outside again, but I'm using a thicker thread and I'm going to go all the way around in a circle. And each time I do the small stitch that goes off to the side, I'm going to put it in towards the center and just move it around like that. And what I'll end up with is a flower shape. I'm using a variegated thread so that it really shows up nicely. And I'll go on and do more. Some with variegated, some not, and just do a huge group of flowers if I can. So just like this one, some small, some large, some only parts, you know, maybe they're buds or you're only seeing the top of it. And I'll just keep going like that. So I'll also add in a little bit of, a bit more grass or bushes or whatever they are with our blanket stitch. This time I've loaded on a light green wool and I've put quite a long thread, and you see how I'm really having to pull there and it might get knotted. So simply pull that tail a little bit further through the eye of your needle so that you're only pulling through half as much. And then as you get further along, you just, you know, pull it back out again as you need it. So let's have a closer look. That looks quite effective, I think. A few flowers there. Very nice. I even did some that had the spoke-like stitches going outwards and the straight stitch going in the center. See that white one? That worked quite well. It was like a little star-shaped one. You could do probably a sun like that or other things. But look at that, that looks really well. Here we go, we're going to just have a look at some that I've done in the past and shown you just how nice it can be. So you can see I'm using a blanket stitch here in this lovely tangerine burnt orange. And I'm just having different sizes. You see, small, large, medium, medium, small. And just staggering it, so it makes quite a pretty edge. Here in a toning colour, I've used it to add a piece of ribbon into a really nice fabric collage I did, same there. Here, I'm just showing you some flowers in a lovely textural work. So I hope this has given you some ideas as to how you can use blanket stitch in some of your creative textile art. My name's Tracey. And I hope you've enjoyed this little video. If you have, do press like and subscribe. And any of my other details are down below. Thanks for watching.